95 million years after cellular life, near the Nibhalil coast, we find these tiny creatures sticking their front ends from the sediment. They are Lenicutis virgiforma, a species of eelworm. Specifically, their genus Lenicutis belongs to a clade of eelworms called the Munchers. Eelworms are divided into three major clades. The smallest and oldest clade, the hairworms, have a maximum length of 1 cm. They are detritivores, which inhabit soft soil in shallow areas like the Topeka Gulf. They burrow underground and make tunnels, where they spend their whole lives. They only ever come out to reproduce, like their relatives we saw earlier. They are broadcast spawners, releasing their gametes from a reproductive patch in their skin near their front end. Their gametes mix in the water and their embryos develop without any kind of protection. Most embryos are eaten before they can even be properly called babies, and even the adults are often preyed upon by larger organisms. The second oldest clade are the Munchers. Unlike the hairworms, which simply possess an opening near their front end, the Munchers do have a semblance of a mouth, with 6 appendages which can be filled with fluid to move forwards and backwards. They use these mouth parts to dig more effectively and to hold small food items, which in their case do include smaller organisms. The largest and newest clade of eelworms is the sister clade to the Munchers, called the spike faces. They only have 4 mouth parts, which have hardened at the tip to form a kind of beak, which they use to hold and restrain their prey, as this clade is mostly made up of predators. They mostly live underground, but some species, like the pictured specimen of Ornithophasius striatus, commonly venture out of their tunnels to capture prey. These species notably have more color variety. Eelworms are among the most basal sucker descendants. They're mostly made up of muscle, with rings of expanding compartments lining their whole bodies. They have a small digestive tube spanning around half of their bodies, and no real stomach nor through gut. Their nervous system is mostly decentralized, but they do have what is starting to become a brain in their middle. This is due to their tuboid ancestry and their embryonic development. This central area is the first to develop, and contains the mother cell made up from 2 combined gametes. Besides the reproductive patch near the front end, they do not have much else to their anatomy, yet. That's all for now, this is Hnrrienkast signing off. Thank you.